Hi everybody, I'm Albert. I'm staff member at the Center for High Performance Computing, and today we will be talking about modules. So in the olden days of CHPC, we used a system of scripts that you would source in order to gain access to software packages. And that worked and it was effective, but it was also kind of cumbersome in some ways. And we've recently adopted the modules software for environment management instead of that sourcing system in order to align ourselves with the national computing centers and a few different other things. And so it's really a useful piece of software because it allows you to manipulate your environment and load up only the things you want, or if you want you can unload software packages, which is really useful. Now, we've selected to use the Texas Advanced Computing Center of Modules, LMOD. There's other versions of it which are useful, but this one is the most feature-rich version of it, and so that's why we're using this. Now, by default, new users should be using modules already. If you don't have modules set up, then you can get them pretty easily. You need to copy over the bashrc or tcshrc files for your respective shell. If you need to figure out what your shell is, just use echo $shell. We also have some extra scripts, these custom.sh and custom.csh scripts, which will set up a default CHPC environment and allow users to customize their environment very cleanly. I'm going to leave it to you, the user, to do this. This is on our website, which is under the software modules section. If you don't have modules set up and you need help with that, then please contact us at issues@chcc.utah.edu. Now, assuming that you do have modules set up correctly, like I have here on my test account, we'll go through the basic commands and the features and just exactly how this all works. So the most basic command for modules is just simply the module command. So if I type that in and hit enter, you can see it gives me a useful help dialog. So you can see that there's a lot of different commands and a lot of different ways to do it. But if you're seeing this, then you know that modules are working correctly. Now the next commands that are important are the commands module list and module avail. So module avail shows you a list of packages which are available to be loaded immediately. So you can see here that there are a number of packages that we have available. Of particular interest are these ones that are under CHPC core, which is where you'll find a lot of the commonly used packages. We also have MPI packages that you can use, which are used to access specific software that is compiled for different clusters and for parallel use. Now, module avail shows you what you can immediately load, but module list shows what you already have loaded. So you can see that I only have one module loaded right now, which is the Intel compiler. And for a lot of things at CHPC, this is how you want to start out with your default environment, because the Intel compiler gives you access to a lot of the packages that we have installed. So the basic command to load a module is simply module load. So if we come up here and look for a module to load, let's say we want to load the MATLAB module. So you can see that we have three different modules here for it. We have 2014A, 2014B, 2015A. And you can see that we have one of them with a D next to it. The D stands for default. So if I simply execute module load MATLAB, then you'll see that it loads 2015A, which is the default module. Now let's say I didn't want that module. You can just do module load MATLAB R2014B. And that will automatically reload the module. There's another command that you can use, which is module swap, which you can use if you have a module already loaded. which allows you to swap that module with another module or of the equivalent peer level, you might say. So I could simply do module swap MATLAB R2014B for R2014A. And if we do a module list, you see that R2014A is loaded now. Now, let's say that I don't want MATLAB in my environment. For example, there are certain Python modules that will not play nice with MATLAB, and that can break your environment. You can simply do module unload MATLAB, and if we follow it up by a module list, you see that there is no longer MATLAB loaded. So this is useful if you want to switch environments quickly. This is especially useful if you're doing development work for a software package. Now at CHPC, there are certain modules that we have that are not immediately available. For example, there is the software called LAMPS, which is a molecular dynamics software, which if we try and do a module load on LAMPS, we see that it complains that they exist but cannot be loaded. And so you see here that it tells you that there is a command module spyder lamps, which will tell you how to load that module. Spyder is a really useful command because it allows you to see all of the packages available on the system regardless of whether or not they can be loaded immediately. So if you just type module spyder, it'll show you a list of all of the modules which are available at CHPC. If you do module spyder followed by a module name, for example, LAMPS, then it'll show you what versions of that are available, and it will give you instructions on how to see how to load that module. So if we follow the example that it gave here, and do module spyder LAMPS 28 June 14, it tells us that this module can only be loaded through the following modules: Intel 2015, nvpitch 2/2.0.kp.i. So on our cluster we have several MPI versions. We have nvpitch, we have Intel MPI, mpitch, OpenMPI I think we also have. But we also have multiple clusters, and our different MPI distributions are compiled specifically for different clusters. And so we have different designations for that, but in this instance you can see that we have the .kp, but if we do a module avail, you can see that we have other versions. For example, we have a general build, which is just 2.0.i, 2.1 RCI 2.i. We can also load up a different compiler, for example, the GCC compiler. Which, if we do a module avail again, you can see that we have GCC versions of nvpitch 2 as well. So it's up to the user to figure out which one of these they want to use, but you have to be careful and you have to make sure to use the right designations. Are you using the King's Peak or are you using the general build? Are you using the Intel build or are you using the GCC build? Regardless of that, if we do module spyder LAMPS, it tells us for this particular version that we want to load that. So you can do this in one single command. You do module load Intel 2015.1.133 nvpitch 2/2.0.kp.i, and then if we do a module avail, we see now that LAMPS is available to us. So now we can simply do module load LAMPS, and if we do module list, you see that LAMPS is now loaded. And so this is how you would load an MPI enabled software. Now there are a couple more useful commands that we can use. One of them is module save. And what module save does is it will save a collection of modules, which you can then unload. So if we use the module command purge, which unloads all of the modules, you see that we don't have any modules. But I just ran the module save command. So if I do module restore, we can see that it says that the default modules were restored. And if we do a module list, we see that we are exactly where we were when we just left off. Now, if you want to save a different list, for example, you could do module save followed by a name. For example, development. Now, to see the list of those, you do module save list. And you see that there are two collections, default and development. If we wanted to load development, then we would simply do module restore development, which is obviously the same module list here, but this is a way to have different module environments. Now, one additional thing which I'll point you towards is that we have an advanced section of our modules documentation, which can tell you how to write and use your own modules, which is fairly straightforward. It's simply just a Lua script that uses some specific commands, which you can see at the TAC website on their module commands tutorial. And so if you're interested in setting up your own custom environment, you're perfectly capable of doing that yourself. And if you need help with that, then please contact CHPC. And with that, that's the end of this tutorial. I hope you learned something about modules. If you're interested in other tutorials, or if you have any questions, then you can visit our website or email us at issues@chcc.utah.edu. You can also visit us in room 405 at INSCC. And thank you for watching.